Hi, my name is Lokesh, and I would like to welcome you all in our today's classroom, and where we are learning about career in engineering, and we are trying to understand different domains of engineering. So today we are going to learn something about civil engineering. Like how we have learned electrical and electronic engineering in our first class, then we have learned about mechanical and automobile industry engineering in our second class, and then now we'll be understanding all about civil engineering. So what do you mean by civil engineering? Let's try to understand through this in this classroom. So civil engineers plan, design, construct, manage in the construction of the projects. The projects span from various domains, including transportation, water supply, waste management, state planning, and even taking up the offshore projects. Offshore projects means like the project which are on the sea, like say oil rigs and all other stuff. Civil engineers assume two roles, that of consultant, or you can say you give guidance to the companies, or you can be a contractor. Contractor means you take up a whole project and you start from scratch to building whatever you want to, client wants to make for them. You are, as a contractor, you are facilitating or you are assisting them in the execution of particular project. So you can have a two role, consultant and the contractor. Consultant works with the client to plan, design and manage the projects. The contractor supervises the construction and manage the project from on the ground level to turn plans into the realities. So consultant is a soft role and the contractor is a hardcore role. Consultant is giving them a suggestion, plan, design and manage the project. Contractor do the real things as he turns up the paper projects, the live realities as a live projects. So this is about civil engineering. Now in our now we are going to understand the career scope in civil engineering. So one by one we are going to take up the career scope and try to understand what the point I am highlighting, and you will be getting to know what are the career scopes in civil engineering as a career. So first is like structural engineering. Civil engineering in this field create structural element of design of a bridge, skyscraper, ports, airports, etc. They also design, assess major projects such as buildings, bridges, dams to ensure their strength and the durability. So first point is structural engineering. The second is geotechnical engineering. Civil engineers in this field exclusively with the rock and the soil that support the structure and make sure that the foundation are solid. So they are working out with the geotechnical, like say a rock and the soil where the building is going to be constructed. They focus on how the structure built by civil engineers such as building and tunnel or interact with the earth, including soil and rock. So the structure interact with the earth, so there are soil and rocks inside the earth. In addition, they design plan for slopes, retaining walls and the tunnels. So these are the second career scope, that is geotechnical engineering. The third is environmental engineering. Civil engineers in this field design the system structure for treatment of chemical, biological and thermal waste. Fourth, material engineering is like civil engineers in this field deal with inspection of existing and the development of new material which can be used for construction of the projects. Okay, so this is material engineering. The fifth one is maintenance. Civil engineering in this field ensure that the structure built are looked after properly and all necessary repairs and renovation takes place. Then the sixth point is water resource engineering. Civil engineering in this field focus on collection, storage and management of the water. Then seventh is earthquake engineering. Civil engineers specialize in this field create building and the structure of that can withstand with the stresses of earthquake without failing. So they do R&D related to earthquake, possible earthquake damage in the future. Coastal engineering. So the in this point, coastal engineering, civil engineering specialize in this field, manage the coastal areas including marshlands. They create defenses against flooding and erosion. So I repeat all the points once again. First is structural engineering, geotechnical engineering, environmental engineering, material engineering, maintenance engineering, water resource engineering, earthquake engineering, coastal engineering. So this all type of engineering comes into the civil engineering as a major domain, and these are also some domains of civil engineering which is called become a specialized in this particular domain of the civil engineering. These are the point which we have understood. Now we'll go through with the important points for getting into the college which provide civil engineering degree. So most of the college eligibility criteria of minimum 50% aggregate marks in class 12, some of the college have a mark of 60% also. Must have passed class 12 senior secondary examination with at least 50% mark including English. Some examination requires JE score as a minimum eligibility. So you have to pass your JE joint entrance. Some of the college, good reputed college, look into your joint entrance examination JE score as a minimum eligibility criteria. Some colleges, universities also have an age limit for that. So these are the important point to get into the good college of you can say civil engineering. So now we are going to the list of engineering institution in India, or you can say top engineering institution in India which provide degree in civil engineering. These are Indian Institute of Technology, all Indian Institute of Technology, which are in multiple locations. Birla Institute of Technology, National Institute of Technology, Calicut, National Institute of Technology, Silchar, National Institute of Technology, Suratkar, National Institute of Technology, Bhopal, Vellore Institute of Technology, Chennai, Indian School of Mines, Dhanbad, Sri Ramaswamy Memorial University, SRM, multiple location. Then we have Pandit Deen Dayal Petroleum University, Gandhinagar, St. Andrews Institute of Technology, Gurugram, PhD College of Technology, Coimbatore, Maharashtra Institute of Technology, Pune, Manipal University, Manipal, you can say in Manipal and Jaipur. You can have Anna University, that's in Chennai, Madras Institute of Technology, that is in Chennai, Motilal Nehru Institute of Technology, that is Uttar Pradesh, and then PEC University of Technology, that is in Punjab. Here we are having some top institution in world which provide engineering degree in civil engineering, which are the institution are University of Manchester, University of New South Wales, University of California, Berkeley, University of College of London, Imperial College of London, Massachusetts Interior Technology, Delft University Technology, Harvard University, National University of Singapore, Caltech and University of Michigan, University of Toronto, and Purdue University. These are the top institution which gives you degree for civil engineering, and these are the top institution. There are a lot of institution available in world, but these are the top out of a lot of institution. We have some of the major entrance examination for getting into the engineering college which provide civil engineering as your degree, okay, and your undergraduation. So these are the same entrance examination which are like JE Advanced in month of April, J Advanced in month of May and June, National Engineering Aptitude Test, that is called NEAT NAT, is in June, then Birla Institute of Technology and Science Admission Examination, that is in May, Bedside, Education Promotion Society of India, National Admission Test, that is in April and May, Vellore Institute of Technology Engineering Entrance Examination, that is in month of April, University of Delhi Combined Entrance Examination, that is in June, Medical Engineering and Dental College of Karnataka, May, Admission Test for ICFA, Science and Technology, that is in month of May, and then we'll be having SRM University Engineering Entrance Examination in April, Manipal University Online Entrance Examination, that is in March and April, Indraprastha University and Common Entrance Test, that is in May, and now for the post-graduation, once you get out from the graduation of as a civil engineer, if you would like to go for a post-graduation, then you have to give an examination, that is which is called Graduate Aptitude Test in Engineering, that is called GATE, that takes place in Jan and Feb. So now we will try to understand the basic work description of you being a civil engineer. So what you are going to do when you are getting a degree of civil engineering. So these are some of the points. First is create graphical representation of civil structure. Inspect project site to monitor progress and ensure compliance with the design of specification and safety and standards. Or you can say monitor progress, ensure compliance with design specification safety standards. Provide technical advice to industrial and managerial personnel regarding design, construction, structural repairs. Estimate quantities and the cost of material, equipment, labor cost to determine project feasibility. Test building materials such as concrete, asphalt, steel for use in particular projects. Consider construction cost, government regulation, potential environment hazard, and the And the pointers in planning stages carry out risk analysis also. Compile and submit permit application to the local, state, federal agencies or government agencies. Verify the project comply with the various regulations. And the last point, you may have to work when you are getting into the civil engineering as a career. Present findings, or you can say research to public on topics such as bid proposal, environment impact and other reports related to your work descriptions. So now we are trying to understand the advantages and the disadvantages of career in civil engineering. So what are the advantages? So the advantage is demand for civil engineering remains advantages. So does the pay package. So civil engineer is an evergreen field, and in civil engineering there are a lot of fields comes into the civil engineering which we have gone through when we are trying to understand the career scope in civil engineering. And this is the evergreen field, and the more you are best in the work which you do, the more will be your package. They may major figures involve the development of the community. They play major a role in the community development. Opportunity to travel different location and work on different sites. These are the advantages. Now the disadvantages is like it is high pressure job. So you are always be on your toes because it's a high pressure job. You need to be heavy. You be a little proactive and a little analytical in your work execution. There are no fixed hours. They spend much time on construction site and remote location. Scrutiny of quality work and material from the third party. Yes. So there are disadvantages when you cannot do anything like that way. You have to be very precise in the work which you do, because there are a lot of scrutiny of the quality and the work and the material from the third party inspection which inspect your work or the construction or the site. So here in this session or in classroom, what we understood is like we understood about the basics of civil engineering or the domain of civil engineering once you get into civil engineering. So we have understood about the basic description of civil engineering. Then we have gone through with around 8 aspect, or you can say 8 career scope in civil engineering. Then there's an important point. Then we have gone through with the all top engineering colleges in India. Then we have gone through the top engineering college in the world. Then there are the entrance exam happening in India for getting into the degree college of engineering, degree college of civil engineering. Then we've gone through with the work description, what you need to do in civil engineer, and then we have understood the basic idea, or you get a little basic idea about the advantages and the disadvantage of working as a civil engineer. So thank you so much for your time. In next session we are going to come up with a new domain of engineering where you understand the other aspect or other field of engineering like the way we have understood in our previous classrooms. Thank you so much.